Okay. I just gotta see Ward at that weight.
Yeah, I need to see like 5'5" at 175.
Ward is one of the most skillful, adaptive fighters that I've
seen. Let me ask you about your t-shirt. This was a real rivalry. Now they're cool. They work together. Fernando Vargas, Oscar De La Hoya, bad blood. Who has the biggest beef right now in boxing? Legitimate, because that was legit. When they really did not like
each other. Rios Ortiz.
Rios Ortiz. Would that sell pay-per-view?
I don't know, to be honest with you.
I don't pay attention to that beef stuff because you know, you're around the gyms and you know sometimes those beefs are a lot of crap.
That was real. Yeah. Floyd, and Rios Ortiz is real.
I know you're in Garcia's gym, Tim Rios. Yeah. Team Rios. Yeah.
He's fighting Tim Bradley in 13 days.
Yeah, good luck to you, man.
Yeah. I mean, I don't think Ortiz is going to hang out with Rios.
But
when push comes to shove, Rios will give up some rounds and then Rios will tough him.
Yeah.
That's just the bottom line.
If they do fight, I think it sells out StubHub, sells out Staples Center.
Well, who wouldn't want to see
StubHub? StubHub needs that war.
Yeah, StubHub would be great because I love StubHub. Staples Center's a little too big.
Okay, Victor said that he wants to fight Ocito. Ocito wants to fight Victor. A rematch, the first one Ocito won, of course. What do you think?
I don't know. I don't want to get down on Victor, but I've seen a lot of bad performances in a row, and I just don't know if he has the confidence to be a champion and to do what he needs to do to be a champion. I'm not saying he can't, but right now, I got to see it. I got to see him not blow up in a fight and maintain his composure all the way through and do what he needs to do. It's a very hard thing to do at that level, so I'm not disrespecting him, but I don't think he has the same champion. He doesn't wear the same champion belt like the way some of the other guys do.
By the way, Coach, congratulations. Unless it's an old picture, you and me at St. John recently won a fight?
Yeah.
Tell us about that. When was that? And
it was last week. It was her last fight. She said she's retired, but I've heard that from her from before. And
you worked the corner?
I worked the corner.
Congratulations.
Yeah, it was fun.
How does it feel to work a pro corner?
I've done a few before.
He's done a championship. She's worked the championship corner.
Yeah, I worked her corner when she did the WBC championship.
Okay.
And you know, the interesting thing was she got in there and pushed really, really hard the entire fight. I was really impressed with the conditioning, and I always knew she was tough. But when it came down to it, you know, she boxed for a little while because that was the plan, so she got the timing of her opponent. And when she got the timing of her opponent, she just kept coming and coming and coming. Bell to bell. The bell rang. The referee had to split them apart, send her back to the corner. The bell rang for the next round. She'd pop up off the stool and run right across the ring to go fight again. So for her last performance, didn't really see the kind of age that I expected. I'm not saying she shouldn't retire. You get to be a certain age, you're taking a certain amount of punches over a certain amount of fights, and you gotta watch yourself. But really great performance. I was very proud of her.
Who wrapped her heads?
I did.
Good job, Coach. See?
Yeah, I've wrapped a couple thousand hands by now.
Yeah.
Never had a break.
Pro and amateurs.
No, not anymore. It used to be.
You're cool.
It used to be a lot different, but it's not now really the rules are the same.
Coach, do you see another Mia St. John coming out of this gym?
You know, we have some really great female fighters here. They come on Sundays to spar from our gym and from other gyms. I got to tell you, man, the girls work really, really hard. And I've got to cut off their sparring. Unlike the guys, and I'm not dissing guys, but a lot of times after 3 or 4 rounds, 5, 6 rounds, depending on their experience, when it's over, they're ready to come down. But these girls keep bugging me, and sometimes I get stuck here a half hour late because they just want to keep sparring. They just love it.
All right, there you have it. Coach Cliff right here at Outlaws. Congratulations on the victory with me at St. John, our last win, last fight. BusinessReport.com and Melissa Crack reporting.